Friends, welcome back to Drawing Conversation. I am your dedicated nerd host and artist, Danny Fisher. And today, I want to draw for you the origin and history of Batman. But because it is February and Valentine's, I want to draw five of my favorite love interests of the Dark Knight. So let's get started. Folks, before we start drawing, I just want to say thank you so much. I truly appreciate your support. Thank you so much for subscribing. And if you haven't already, please go ahead, subscribe, like, leave a comment. And if you know anyone who likes Batman, please share this video. Now, I'm sure you already know Batman's origins because it's been told like 100,000 times. But if you're not familiar, allow me to bring you up to speed. Batman was created by artist Bob Kane and writer Bill Finger. He initially debuted in issue number 27 of Detective Comics on March 30th, 1939. Looking pretty good for being over 80. Batman was born to one of the richest families in the world. He was born to Thomas and Martha Wayne. And Bruce was raised in the very lap of luxury until at the very young age he witnessed his parents murdered and vowed to dedicate his life to fighting crime. It was this dedication that pushed Bruce to the very peak of physical strength, speed, and athleticism. He also goes on to learn to speak dozens of languages, study psychology, sociology, mathematics, chemistry, physics, biology, you name it, he's gone out and studied it. He's also mastered over 100 forms of martial arts. Moreover, Batman has become a true master of criminal sciences and observation. In fact, in my opinion, this is what separates Batman from all other crime fighters. It's his ability to observe the tiniest details. Now, this is on par, if not better, than the great Sherlock Holmes. Batman has also designed dozens of bat suits over the years, each designed for a specific task. And he's also equipped with the Bat Belt, which is like the ultimate bag of holding. It carries hundreds of gadgets that can help him in virtually any situation. What's more, he is a master of disguise and espionage. This allows him to slip in and out of shadows without being traced. Yes, I know it's a lot, but keep your comic book hats on. At any rate, now you're totally up to speed on the Caped Crusader. And seeing how this is my February / Valentine's episode, I wanted to count down my favorite love interests of the Dark Knight. Please keep in mind, this is not a complete list of everyone the billionaire playboy has dated, but instead it is my top five. Landing at number five is Zatanna Zatara. Zatanna is a half-human, half-homo magi. And this is an ancient race that has lived alongside humans for, well, since the beginning of time. She was raised by her father and taught conventional magic, you know, sleight of hands, force of will, distraction, you know, simple magic tricks. But as she mastered those, her father would start teaching her real magic, and they would introduce that magic onto their stage performances, making it truly a one-of-a-kind show. Her shows always seemed to me to be kind of a blend of Vegas magic meets New Orleans burlesque. Zatanna first met Bruce as a child and was one of the few playmates Bruce had growing up. In fact, it was Zatanna who taught Bruce the art of escape. Think of Harry Houdini only on a grander level, if you can imagine that. The two would eventually meet up as adults and become entwined in a deep romance. But in the end, it was Bruce who ended the relationship as he didn't want Zatanna to see his dark side. Which, when you think about it, is kind of funny, because when you look at the caliber of villains Zatanna has fought, it's enough to make Batman cringe. Coming in at number four is Princess Diana of Themyscira, better known as Wonder Woman. Formed from the clay by her mother Hippolyta and her father being Zeus, Diana was raised by the Amazonians. She possesses super strength, speed, and durability. She's armed with a host of weapons, but my favorite is the Lasso of Truth. Now, this Lasso of Truth will compel anyone to speak the truth, as well as show their true character. And I wish I had that lasso for some of my ex-girlfriends. Not important. What's important is just Diana is a master with virtually all weapons, and is without a doubt one of the most powerful members of the Justice League. My first introduction to Wonder Woman was the 1970s show starring Linda Carter. Sorry, Gal Gadot. Linda will always be my Wonder Woman. Now, to be 100% fair, Bruce and Diana never really had an official relationship, at least not in the comics, but it was always alluded to. They were always exchanging glances and have kissed on more than one occasion. And what happens off panel stays off panel. My number three is the one and only Talia al Ghul. She is the daughter of Ra's al Ghul, or Ra's if you want to get fancy. He is a true mastermind of evil. He rules a secret faction known as the League of Assassins and is the controller of the Lazarus Pool, a mysterious pool that can bring people back from the dead. Talia has a fierce loyalty to her father and serves as his right-hand man. Talia is an extremely proficient martial artist and tactician. What I love about the first appearance of Talia was that she had staged an elaborate kidnapping plot, along with the help of her father Ra's, to see if Batman would make a suitable mate. And with Batman's success, Talia informs him that they are now married. You see, in Talia's culture, only the female has to have consent for the marriage to be official. And it wasn't hard for Bruce to fall deeply in love with Talia and soon discover she is pregnant. You know what else isn't hard? Hitting that subscribe button. But really, it helps me out a lot. Now, Talia goes on to lie to Bruce and tell him she actually lost the baby. And soon after, the two part ways, only for her to show up years later with a teenage son named Damian and tells Batman that this is his son. I mean, who just shows up and says that? I don't know. What's really cool is that Damian goes on to be the newest and my personal favorite, Robin. Number two is Vicki Vale, created by Bob Kane and Bill Finger. Her first appearance was in Batman number 49 as the hard-nosed photojournalist for the Gotham Gazette. Introduced at a time when people were kind of questioning Batman's sexuality. I mean, he was running around with a teenage boy in tights. Vicki Vale was created to be Batman's version of Lois Lane. And what's funny is she's the first person to question if Batman and Bruce Wayne are really the same person. And this is a topic that continued throughout the comic whenever she appeared. Now, she doesn't have superpowers, nor is she trained to be an assassin or any such mess. What she brings is 100% class. And I loved her first film appearance in Tim Burton's 1989 Batman. This Batman film was my favorite of all time. And yes, I have to say it, Kim Basinger, I think I love you. And sitting firmly at number one is Selina Kyle, better known as Catwoman. When the two first met, it was pretty much lust at first sight. I still remember watching reruns of the 1960s Batman TV series and thinking Julie Newmar was the hottest woman alive. Now, Catwoman was raised in an extremely abusive home. And after the death of both of her parents, she grows up in an orphanage. As a trained gymnast, she's able to sneak in and out of the orphanage and soon finds herself in a life of crime. On one special night, she's actually robbed by a ninja. Amazed that someone could get the jump on her, she follows this ninja back to his underground hideout. And when she's discovered, the master of this clan, sensing something special in Selina, offers to train her. With this training and her natural abilities, she goes on to be one of Batman's biggest headaches. You see, Catwoman has been friend, foe, lover and enemy, and most recently, fiance. I really think that's what the fans love about Catwoman. It's the constant twists and turns. You never know what she's gonna do next. Guys, like I've said before, the Brooding Bats has had many love interests over the years, and these are just my personal favorites. Over the years, I have loved reading Batman, not just for the great stories and crime-fighting adventures, but to see if Batman will ever settle down. Friends, thank you so much for watching. Your support means more than you can imagine. And if you haven't already, please hit that like, hit that subscribe, turn those notifications on, and leave a comment below. Let me know your favorite love interest of the Caped Crusader, and I will talk to you again soon.